So I'm Nick Kyme. I'm one of the authors of The Dawn of Fire. I am the writer of The Iron Kingdom, which is the fifth book in the series. And today we're going to learn about why you should be excited about what's going to come next. So The Dawn of Fire is the ongoing 40k series that's set during the era Indomitus from Black Library. It features characters like Vitrian Messinius, who is going to be made into a wonderful miniature that you can use in your tabletop games. He featured initially in the first book called Avenging Sun, and he shows up again in Dawn of Fire Book 5, The Iron Kingdom. So it's the ongoing sort of 40k saga that followed the fleets that are heading out as part of the Indomitus Crusade. I suppose the big sort of beat storylines, the ongoing sort of saga, is the ongoing crusade. So we get to follow Fleet Tertius and Fleet Primus primarily, or aspects of those fleets as they prosecute Guilliman's crusade to sort of settle, if you like, Imperium Sanctus. That's like the big sort of driving force behind this story. There are some ongoing themes, such as the appearance of the Hand of Abaddon, which is a mysterious enemy that the various characters in the stories are trying to figure out who that is, or what that is, and what the agenda is. And some of that has been built in the initial sort of four books. There are several recurring characters that also come up in Dawn of Fire Book 5, which we'll get to kind of see their kind of ongoing sort of storylines. Dawn of Fire Book 5 takes place primarily on a night world called Kamadar. And the first time we heard about Kamadar was in The Gate of Bones, which is Book 2 in the Dawn of Fire series. And several of the characters that we met in that story will appear in Book 5. The sort of driving force behind this particular novel is as a group, a big sort of section of Fleet Primus called Battle Group Praxis, which have come to Kamadar for two reasons. The first one is to sort of refit and resupply. The Indomitus Crusade is grueling on all the forces that take part in the sort of reconquest of Imperium Sanctus. And the further away they get from Terra or the different sort of bastions where they're getting sort of reinforced, the harder it is. It's like they're stretching the empire further and further out. So Kamadar is a vital sort of resource point. The second reason they're going to Kamadar is they're bringing back the body of the Queen's daughter. So there's lots of kind of emotions that are sort of flying back and forth. It's a very difficult reunion for Kamadar, who have been sort of surviving independently of the Imperium for quite a while. And when the Imperium shows up in the form of Battle Group Praxis, they immediately set about taking all the things they need from the Night World, all the sort of material and troops they want. And at the same time, in a sort of fairly sort of perfunctory fashion, deliver the Queen's daughter back to her. So there's a lot of friction that starts to occur between these two sort of rival forces. There's a really important subplot in this story too, which involves a new Black Templar character called Morrigan the Unchained, and a Red Corsair who's called Grail Herrick. So those two are rivals from before the Great Rift kind of split the galaxy in two, and they're thrown together in this story again. So against that backdrop of Imperial Civil War and unrest, then there's some pretty shocking twists that happen in this story too, which hopefully folks won't see coming. In fact, I'm 99% sure they will not see those coming. And we get to see this kind of other mini sort of meta play sort of run out, which is the Black Templars and the Red Corsair sort of going at each other. So some of the other key characters we've got in this story that have come from Gate of Bones that people might recognise are Mag Dakesh. So she's from the Mordian 110th. She's a Pathfinder Sergeant. The last time we saw her in Gate of Bones, she'd survived miraculously in the sort of finale of that book. There was a whole underground subterranean battle, and she kind of makes it out. And we never really find out kind of how or why. This story starts to pull at some of those threads, and we get a bit of a sense of what's really behind Magda Kesh's survival and kind of what might she go on to do next. She's got a really interesting kind of character arc that sort of starts to develop in this book. And we put her alongside a new character called Sereniel, who's a sister of Silence, who's been sent to Kamadar at Artemis's request. There's a whole delegation of folks that essentially return the queen's daughter back to her. There's like it's like an imperial sort of honor guard, I suppose, from the campaign that Jezevane is the name of the queen's daughter that that she was kind of on, and they kind of come with her. And Tyrannial's part of that group, okay? And she gets thrown in with Kesh when stuff happens on the surface of Kamadar. Again, I can't reveal because it'll spoil the story. And Kesh is like heavily involved in that, and her destiny is sort of wrapped up with Sereniel, and we get to see some of that play out as well. So there's lots of interesting threads that come out of this book that we'll get to see play out later, that pull on a lot of stuff that we've already seen in the earlier books.